Hi. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Infranodus knowledge graphs and AI to analyze open-ended survey responses so that you can apply the same approach in your thematic analysis workflows or when you're doing qualitative research. You will be able to visualize the main topics in the responses of people. So, for example, if you're working with the customer feedback or with just answers to questions, you can visualize the main topics inside those answers. So you can get like a quick high-level overview of the main ideas inside and the themes that are present within. And then you can also use the graph to zoom in onto the parts of the discourse that you find interesting. So, for example, here, if I click on client design, then I can see in which context those terms were used together, and I can use this information to then select those statements and tag them appropriately so that I can then export these themes and tags for use in my qualitative analysis workflow. So this is not only useful to extract the general insights, but to also perform thematic analysis and to tag your statements for consequent use in other software as well. And on top of that, not only you can visualize the general overview, you can also find the gaps inside. So this is very good when you want to generate some ideas based on the answers that you're provided, because people might be talking about certain things, but they're not connecting them together. So you can use the graph to identify those gaps, those content gaps in their responses, and then think of some ideas using the AI that could bridge those gaps and help you come up with some solutions for the community or for the clients that you're working with that can solve their problems in ways that they couldn't even foresee. So I think this approach is very useful for a lot of different use cases, and I encourage you to watch it until the end so that you can understand how it works. Also, please subscribe to this channel so that this video can get recommended to other people interested in this content. As an example, as the data, we will actually use the data that was provided to us by Give Internet, which is a charity that is providing internet access and laptops to various underserved communities. For example, they offer it to students, to the people in refugee camps, low-income communities. So what they're doing is really great, and they basically performed a survey of the people that they provided laptops to ask them how their lives has changed after they got the laptop. So we will visualize this as an example and see what are the answers that people provide when they respond to this question. So first of all, I will show you how you can import the data. You need to go to the apps and then analyze text files, and then you upload a CSV file. And then basically when you choose the CSV file, the first window will ask you which column you want to analyze. So here I want to analyze the responses where they say, how has your life changed after receiving a laptop from Give Internet? All right, so this is the column we're analyzing. And then the second part is the column that you will use as a filter. So for example, we can use the organization that referred you to this project or the location, or we can use both as well, right? So if you have not so many values in this column, then you can use it as filter, because you will be able to see how the people from different organization or from different location are answering differently. Okay, so then we click next, give a name to this graph, click visualize, and then what happens now is that Infranodus extracts the terms, the words from the column that we're analyzing, where they were answering how their life has changed. And then it uses the filters here, and then it enables us to filter by those selections as well. So the first thing that you can do is to open the analytics panel on the right, if you click this button here, and then you see the main ideas inside. You also can toggle this switch so that you can see it directly on the graph. And you can see what they're talking about is mainly online learning, so it helped them learn stuff, digital access, skill development, and work efficiency. So we see directly that they say how they were affected is that they enabled themselves to learn something online, to provide digital access, to develop their skills, and to work more efficiently. And also, by the way, creative design here, which is a really interesting feedback as well. And what we can do now in Infranodus is that we can select a topic. So for example, this one, if it's a bit unclear, we can select it, and then we can ask the AI to summarize the selected topic. And then we can actually choose the model that we'll be using for this. Now we're using Gemini 2.5 Pro. So that one is a little bit slower, but you can use GPT-4o. It's faster, or the mini models, they usually work quite well for summarization. So what's happening now is that Infranodus extracts all the statements that are filtered here, 36, so it's 12% of statements that belong to this topic, creative design, and then it provides us an idea of what those topics are about. So this is a really nice way to summarize really quickly what people are talking about in relation to a specific topic. So you select this topic here, and then you click summarize selected, and then it's going to summarize these statements and these terms. It uses the underlying graph structure to give you an idea of what this is about. So here, for example, it's saying the synergy between interest and design is revolutionizing learning environments in regions such as Mathare in Nairobi and Kibera. So we see that actually the learners can explore platforms, new platforms, learn something new and become more creative in their work. So this is kind of like an overview of this topic. And if you're doing thematic analysis, what you can also do is to select those statements that you just filtered using this topic, right? So if you want to tag all those statements with this topic, you can simply select them and then click the tag here and then write creative design or give them another name, right? And then what's going to happen now, if you save them, all these topics, they will have this tag now, creative design, so that later when you export this data, you will have those statements tagged with this tag that is based on the topic that you identify. So this will be very useful for the people who do thematic analysis or qualitative analysis. It's very fast, AI assisted, and you also can do this manually. For example, if you zoom in here and you want to see what people were saying about cyber skills, especially using those words, right? You can also see the statements where they actually say this. And then you could also, they're already selected, so you can actually tag them with cyber skills. So you can also tag statements by the selections. And this is very good because you can basically keep track of certain statements where people use certain words or where they're talking about certain things in this very easy way and tag them accordingly. So that's very nice because you can kind of use the graph to jump into the topics or ideas that you find interesting, either by using the analytics panel or manually in the graph, and then tag the statements accordingly and have a better understanding of the content. One other thing that is very useful here is that you can use the content gaps feature. So here in Phrenodus, identify the gaps between the topics that are not so well connected in the answers, and then tries to propose you how you could connect them together. So for example, here we have a gap between digital access, the fact that the laptop gave them access to the internet, and to the world of knowledge, and also creative design, so how they can become more creative with that. And then we can ask the AI to think of this connection. We also can think of the connection ourselves, and this is actually what I like to do first, just to think of the connection myself. But then you can also use the AI question mode here for it to generate a possible question that will help you think how those two topics can be connected. And usually it's a very good eureka moment for how you can develop this whole thing further, right? So for example, here it's asking, how does access to laptops and internet connectivity from initiatives like Give Internet impact the development of digital skills and entrepreneurial opportunities in resource-constrained environments such as Mathare, Nairobi, or Kakuma refugee camp? So this is really talking about how Give Internet is helping people, or it's questioning how it's helping people to develop their digital skills and entrepreneurial opportunities. So we can really maybe also focus a little bit more on whether or not it allows them to actually start businesses online and how that works. And then if we reload those questions, then we can generate more. And for example, here there will be something different, like how can laptops serve as essential tools for both personal development and providing underserved communities with internet access. So also this idea of how you use them not only for work, but also to develop yourself, to learn something new and so on. And this could also be an interesting idea for the questions to ask, to follow up, you know, to see how this program could be improved. For instance, can there also be some programs that are offered with the laptop, some free educational programs? What kind of content people would want? Do they want to develop as entrepreneurs, or do they want to develop more their knowledge and skills? So this could be a nice insight of how you can connect those together. And you can actually use the AI to also generate an idea here. So if you click on the idea, then it just generates an idea and then proposes you how you can think about it further. And one last thing I want to show you is that you can also filter this data by the types of answers that people provide. So for example, if you go to filter here, you can see how people answered only in Uganda. And then you can first highlight it in the graph. Usually it's going to overlap quite well. So then you can turn on filter and recalculate analytics. And then you only see the people, the answers of the people from Uganda in this case, right? So what are they talking about? And here we see that they're talking about online growth, digital access, creative tools, project learning, and actually life-changing experience. And when you click on the topics, you can see in which statements they're actually talking about life-changing experience. So you can also summarize them using AI, using this button here, or using this button there. So this really shows us that people from Uganda are talking much more about life-changing experiences than other people. You can add another filter and you can say, okay, I want to see how people from Uganda answer, but also maybe people from Kampala, right? We filter that and then we see those both. So then we can also combine locations. And on top of that, we can even see if there is any intersections, right? So this is a very powerful approach, because if you have tags in your statements already, which we extracted from the CSV file, we can see how people in certain locations answered and what were the topics they used. I will link to another video where I explain how this feature works in more detail from here, so you can watch it and understand how to apply it to your data. So I hope you find this interesting. Let me know if you have any questions. Let me know if you also know of any data sets that you would be interested to analyze this way. And if you just write what you have in mind in the comments, I will be happy to answer to you as soon as possible. Thank you.